Hey, it's your Tech Edit here, and in this video I'll be showing you all of the possible solutions that you could do to fix Adobe Premiere Pro's playback issue. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first solution is to change the sequence settings on Adobe Premiere Pro. So let's go to our desktop. So go ahead and open up Adobe Premiere Pro along with your project that you are working on, and go to the sequence and click on the sequence settings. You'll be able to see here video previews, and select the preview file format to QuickTime, and then go to the codec option and change that one to Apple ProRes LT. You could also select DNX HDR or DNX HD right here. However, I prefer to select the ProRes resolution and select the LT option right here. And for the video preview width, make sure that you only set it at a maximum of 1920 by 1080. So if you are having 2.7K footage, or if you have 4K footage, you could downscale it to 1920 by 1080 first, since you're just looking at the previews, so you don't quite need the full resolution of the media on your timeline. Next, also make sure that these three options right here are unchecked: the maximum bit depth, the maximum render quality, and also the composite in linear color, which again takes more system resources, hence slowing down your Adobe Premiere Pro app. Once then, hit the OK button and go ahead and try and see if that fixes your problem. Second solution is to make sure that Adobe Premiere Pro is allocated with enough or sufficient memory on your system. To do so, simply go to the Edit option right here. Click on Preferences. You'll be shown with this kind of settings right here on the right part, and just select the memory setting. It will show you this preference memory window, and what you are interested in changing is this ROM reserve for other applications. Make sure that you turn this to the lowest possible setting. Make sure to change this as low as possible so that you are allocating as much RAM or memory on your system for Adobe applications. And also change this optimized rendering for performance. Hit the OK button, and it might ask you to restart your Adobe Premiere Pro app. Go ahead and do that one first. Next, to change the playback resolution, make sure that you have your main sequence loaded up, and then go right here. You'll be able to see here, select playback resolution. You could go ahead and try them one at a time, 1/2, 1/4, and 1/8. Basically, they would reduce the resolution of your video previews, hence it will reduce the load on your system. And hopefully that would fix the playback on your Adobe Premiere Pro app. If that didn't still work for you, the third solution is to set the render to utilize your GPU power when rendering frames and playback. To do so, simply go to the file option and click on the project setting and general tab, and it will take you to this window, and make sure that the video rendering and playback renderer is set to Mercury Playback Engine GPU Acceleration CUDA if you have one, or if you don't have, make sure that it is set to the OpenCL version. So once done, simply hit the OK button, and it will ask you again to restart your Adobe Premiere Pro application, and simply follow that one, and hopefully that would fix your playback issue on Adobe Premiere Pro. Another solution that we can do to fix the particular playback issue on Adobe Premiere Pro is to change the render cache folder, or where your media cache is stored on your system. To do so, simply go back to Adobe Premiere Pro app. Go to the Edit option again and click on Preferences, and go to Media Cache right here. So we're going to relocate the location for our media cache files. So click on the Browse button right here, and then select the drive that is not your system drive or where your footages are located. So I have your SSD 120 gigs, and I have here already the particular folders right here. You could just simply create a new folder and rename that one to whatever kind of name that you'd like here. So I have here Adobe Premiere Pro Media Cache folder. Select that particular folder and click on the Select Folder button, and then click this Delete button right here, and it will delete any unused media cache files or the previously rendered media cache files, and hit the OK button. And once done, simply hit the OK button again here, and hopefully again that fixes the problem on your end. Another solution is to create proxy files on your media footages. So if you happen to have high resolution footages, that often comes with also a big file size. It often consumes a lot of CPU resources. Creating a proxy would kind of render a lower resolution of that particular footage and then you could edit that particular footage on your timeline, and you can detach the particular proxy after you have completed the editing process on Adobe Premiere Pro. So to do so, simply go back again to our desktop. So to create proxy, simply go to the project folder or the project window panel on your Adobe Premiere Pro and look for the footages that you have on your project. So I have here a DJI shot footage. So what I'm going to just simply do is simply right click on this one and click on the proxy. You can go ahead and click on the create proxies and change the format to QuickTime and preset to ProRes low resolution proxy. And again, set the destination to a drive where it's not your system drive or where the footages are located. So I have again here the SSD, and I'm going to set that on the rendered parts folder. Hit the OK button once done and it will open up Adobe Media Encoder. It will automatically start the rendering. You'll just have to wait for a few seconds or minutes. Once done, you can now go ahead and close this window and simply right click that particular footage and click on this proxy again and click on the attach proxies. And then you could just simply click on the attach button right here and then go to that particular path where you have just rendered the proxies. So you'll be able to see that particular file because it has the underscore proxy on the file name or of that particular footage. So just click the search button right here and it will find that particular proxy footage and hit the OK button. And it is now already attached on your timeline. So if you're about to render already your final output, just simply right click on your footages and click on the proxy and you could detach the proxies or reconnect the full resolution media. So hopefully that would fix your problem and hopefully you have now faster playback on Adobe Premiere Pro. So another additional tip is if you have lots of effects on your timeline, I would suggest to have them rendered first by hitting the enter button on your keyboard, and it will proceed to rendering all the video previews so that you could have a smooth playback on your timeline. Alternatively, you could go ahead and close this window and then just simply go to the sequence and you'll be able to see here render effects in to out, or you could also click on the render in to out. So once it's done rendering, simply hit the play button and hopefully you have now a faster preview and a smooth playback on your Adobe Premiere Pro. So thanks for watching. Hopefully at least one of all of the possible solutions that I have shown you worked out and fixed the problem that you are encountering right now. Don't forget to leave your comments and feedbacks down below and also like this video if you found this video helpful. I would appreciate it very much. And if you haven't subscribed on this channel yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button and bell notification to get updated with the latest tips and tricks on this channel. Till then, see you in my next videos.